Hi, I'm Esther Eckhart. I'm a yoga teacher. Today it's going to be about lower back pain. I'm going to give you some exercises that will combat that or prevent it. My sister requested it. So Karin, this is for you. She's in Holland, I'm in Ireland, so it's a great way to communicate. One thing to remember when you're in pain is to not go over your boundaries. So as soon as something hurts, you back off. It's all about learning to listen to your body and use your breath. Use your breath. Breathe into the area that's stiff. That's an exercise in itself that works. Okay, let's get starting. First exercise is when you lie on your back with the knees bent and the feet hip width apart. And we're going to flatten the back on the out breath and arch the back on the in breath. And I'll move my arm away so you can see what I'm doing. So on the in breath, you lift the arch, you make the arch stronger. And on the out breath, you flatten the lower back into the floor so the arch disappears. And you do that a couple of times. You do this with the arms next to your body. My arm is just not there to show you. So on the out breath, you flatten and you're looking for the release more than for the boundaries, okay? So when you feel tension, you back off immediately, move into the other arch, and then you find a release. Okay. Then the next, you can do that for about 1 or 2 minutes. The next exercise, you extend your left leg, you flex your foot, and you bring your right knee into your chest and you fold your arms around the leg. Good. Now, you want to focus on not letting your left leg fall out so that the toes fall out and really pressing the top of the left thigh down, and you're extending out through your left heel. So your left leg serves like an anchor. That this is important to anchor your hips as well. Then you draw your knee in a little bit towards the breastbone. Good. And then you have some sort of strap or belt or whatever you want to use for this. And you fold it around, loop it around your foot, and you extend that leg up. Now it's important to have the arms straight. The shoulder blades are connected to the floor and they firm into the floor a little bit. And your leg is straight. Okay, and keep pressing down through the left thigh. And you draw that leg in a little. So you feel a stretch along the back of the leg, but not too far. Breathe into the lower back. Breathe into where you feel pain or stiffness. And then you can hold that for a couple of breaths. Then you hold the belt with only the right hand. The left hand, place it on your left hip. This will be difficult to see. And you apply a little bit of pressure on that hip, inhaling. And on the out breath, you bring that right leg out to the right. You turn the toes out as well. So your knee and toe. Good. And in the meantime, you keep pressing down through the left hip. So you don't let your left hip come off the floor like that. But you're really keeping that press down. So it doesn't matter how far down you get. But you keep that left leg anchored. Good. You hold that for a couple of breaths. And you bring that leg back up. And you release. Slowly. And then we repeat this on the other side. You can feel now that the left, right leg feels a lot longer than the left leg. And it's nice to feel that. Okay, so then you bring your left knee into your chest and you anchor the right leg. Fold the strap around the foot and extend that leg up. And again, take a couple of breaths. Keep pressing the top of the thigh down, anchoring that leg. Place your hand on the hip and on the out breath, you bring the left leg out to the left, up to a point where it feels good to you. So we're looking to release. We're not looking to increase our flexibility. We're working on the lower back pain. Good. And come back up. And release. And again, there's the same length in both legs now. For the next exercise, you turn around. So you come out on the belly and you place your elbows right underneath the shoulders, the armpits, with the hands pointing forward. And the legs are on the floor. You turn your inner thighs out a little bit or towards each other without the heels falling out completely. So you have to find a balance there. Good. You also pull the area between the pubic bone and the belly button in. to support your lower back. It's not a sucking in, but it's just a support, and this is important. Good. And you draw your elbows in a little bit towards your hips, not to actually move them, but it makes you lift the breastbone a bit. So there's quite a lot of stability going on in your upper body, but also in the lower body. And you extend out through the toes. And you just take a few breaths towards the back. And you can stay there again for about between the 1 and the 3 minutes. The next one, you lie down and you place your hands underneath the shoulders. You keep your elbows closed to the body. And your forehead is on the floor. Exhaling. On the in-breath, you come up. And you firm the shoulder blades into the floor. You're not helping with your hands just yet. Keep extending out through the toes. And on the next in-breath, you come up all the way. And here again, you pull the lower belly in. You draw your upper arm bones back. And you drop your shoulders. Good. The lower, the bottom parts of the shoulder blades move towards each other. Keep supporting the lower back, most importantly, by pulling in the belly muscles. Otherwise, it's too much. Your buttocks are firm, but they don't harden, and they move towards the heels. These are all very important instructions to keep space in the lower back and not to compress any vertebrae. Inhaling, exhaling, you come back down, and you rest for a moment. Head on one side, arms next to you. Next, you push yourself up onto your knees, place your hands next to the ribcage, push yourself up, tuck your tailbone, and for a moment, just rest in child pose. You can support your head with your arms, or you can bring your arms to the back, whatever is more comfortable. And in this pose, you want to focus on breathing in the lower belly, and you can feel that your lower back expands as you breathe in and releases as you breathe out. And you really want to hold this pose for as long as it feels good to you. Next, you lie on your back again with the knees bent, and you firm your upper arm bones into the floor, and on the in-breath, you lift your hips, press into the feet. In and outsides of the feet equally. The buttocks move towards the back of the knees, and you're lifting from the breastbone almost. Inner thighs move down, and on the out-breath, you come back down. You can repeat that 3 times. On the in-breath, you lift, and on the out-breath, you lower. And on the 3rd time, you can just hold this pose for 5 or 6 breaths. And again, lower. And then I'd like to end with a twist. With a twist, you bring your arms out to the side. You bring your knees into your chest, inner knees and inner ankles together. And inhaling. On the out-breath, you bring your knees down to your right. Now, you might need to have some support under the knees, depending on how stiff the lower back is. So that's something you might want to think about. And you keep the inner knees and inner ankles together to stabilize the lower back, so the twist happens a little bit above that, more in the mid-upper back. And you can stay here for 5 to 10 breaths. To come back to the center, you use your stomach muscles, exhaling, use the stomach muscles to draw the knees back into the center, and you repeat that to the other sides. Okay, that's it. So this is a sequence that I like to do when I have lower back stiffness or pain and that I would recommend to my students. So now I'd like you to do it, and I'm sure it will help. Good luck.